I'm having sushi the other night in my hometown of Tulsa, Oklahoma. They have a TV over the bar. I happen to look up, and Fox 23 News is doing a story about the atheist billboards that have just come up in Tulsa. And Dave, are you doing those in Oklahoma City as well, in advance of the convention?
We've got them in Tulsa and in Oklahoma City, and we have another design in Albuquerque and Dallas. And I'm really happy with the response that we're getting from all of them.
Now, you know, it's interesting to watch the response because there's a little bit of, you know, the atheists have bought time on an advertising medium here in Jesus. I mean, this is the town of Oral Roberts University. It's the town of Rhema Bible Training Center. There's a church on every half block. We got the praying hands in this town, you know?
Yes.
I mean, there's Jesus. I would call it Jesus Town. And so you put the billboards up. And of course, then they have to go out and interview a pastor to get him to weigh in on it. But talk to me about the campaign itself. Let's sort of set the foundation here first.
Well, again, it's another one of our Christmas campaigns. We do our Christmas campaigns every year. It's the way we attract attention to the fact that you don't have to be a good person to be in, or you don't have to be a Christian to be a good person, and you don't have to be a Christian to like the season. And we're attracting our attention to the fact that the atheists are coming to Oklahoma. So we're having our national convention, of course, in Oklahoma City, March 29th through April 1st, and that's. So what happened was is we come up with a good billboard, the one that went up in Albuquerque and the one that went up in Dallas, that talks about the nativity scene as fake news. It's a good, poignant billboard that gets people to look at the nativity, call it fake news, and actually try and get them to question whether or not they should even go to church in the first place. However, the Oklahoma City and Tulsa markets wouldn't air the billboard. They wouldn't air anything close to the billboard. They wouldn't air a billboard that said skip church at all. They wouldn't air a billboard that poked any kind of fun at Christianity at all. They did, however, acquiesce and allow us to put up a billboard that had the word atheist on it. Ooh. And so the billboard that you saw, and you can see how it works here, because the billboard that you saw was just a Santa Clausy. Just like Santa Claus, the atheists are coming to town. That's what it said.
I mean, the controversial message was, we're arriving.
That's it, but it still worked. So, I mean, if you look at the, in Fighting God, in my book, Fighting God, I talk about the Overton window and how we shifted from place to place. And, you know, in New York, we put up, you know, it's a myth, and we shifted that along. But in Oklahoma City and Tulsa, they are just so afraid of atheists that even poking any fun at Christianity at all is bad, and putting up the word atheist on a billboard is enough to get national. Is enough to get the news story. Just having the word atheist on there is enough to get the news story, and they have to interview the pastor to see what he says, and it shows the need for the atheist convention to be in Oklahoma City. It shows how important it is for our convention to be in the Bible Belt, because let me tell you what there is in Tulsa. There are atheists in Tulsa. Well, let me tell you what there is in Oklahoma City. There are atheists in Oklahoma City. And they feel alone. They live in that situation. They live in a situation where they, if they say the word atheist, it goes on the news. That's where they live. And so what we have done by bringing our convention to Oklahoma City, just like we did in Memphis, just like we did in Salt Lake City, is to bring atheism into the red states to show the people who live there that the atheists are there too, and that they are a thriving and working part of their community. And we're hoping that the people from Tulsa will come to the atheist convention and everybody in Oklahoma City, but also we're hoping that the billboards will get people talking about the fact that there are indeed atheists in Oklahoma, lots and lots of atheists in Oklahoma, that Christians don't own the season, and they sure as heck do not own the state of Oklahoma.
That's a surprise to so many people this time of year. We go through the war on Christmas thing every freaking December. Actually, it starts in October. But, you know, you look at these people who have a tremendous amount of latitude. They can worship any hour of any day. They can put nativities on their front lawn. They've got a Bible in almost every hotel room. There's a good chance their elected representative is a Christian, blah, blah, blah. They've got total carte blanche to be as Christian as they want to be. And somehow they're under attack. And we want to strip the meaning and goodness of Christmas. And, you know, we're just kind of tapping them on the shoulder and saying, hey, you don't have a monopoly on the holiday. And they just hate that.
And they really want the monopoly. That's the thing that Christianity wants. You know, when we fight things like the Ten Commandments on the public lawn, when we fight In God We Trust, when we fight all that stuff, it's all about fighting their perceived monopoly. This is a Christian nation. This is a Christian state. This is a Christian city. We're a Christian world with Christians, 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 and everybody here is Christians. And that's not true, and it's harmful, and it's anti-American, and it's anti-patriotic, and it's very, very negative for the world. So we have to make them realize that their monopoly is not real, that they share this country and this state and this world with people who are very, very different from them. And they're going to have to deal with it. And they don't like to deal with it because, as you know, Seth, they don't like to deal with the doubters because it makes them confront the fact that people don't agree. That makes them confront their own doubts on inside. That's why the preachers resist it. That's why the preachers have to say something about it, because people who are religious don't want to hear that people disagree with them. They just want to hear, you know, the worst thing they want to hear is, well, I have my truth and you have your truth. They don't want to hear I'm right and you're wrong, which is exactly what we say. And we can back it up, of course. They want to have the monopoly. They want to have their bubble, and their bubble is fake. Their bubble is harmful. And it is our job to pop that sucker.
It's interesting, too. You know, people ask, well, you as an atheist, what does Christmas mean to you? And I'm like, well, whatever I want it to mean to me. I mean, Christmas. And, you know, when we did the New York Times campaign, which I was involved in a marginal way, you had a great point, which is all the best stuff about Christmas has nothing to do with Christ. It's and on the billboard, there were all these other things that people do and enjoy that have nothing to do with going to church or believing in myths, right?
Right. I mean, when you think about it, think about even as a religious person, think about what are the best parts about Christmas. You're going to have to get way down that list before you get to church. OK, you have to go way down the list. Family, friends, food, singing, lights, the gifts, the presents, all the shopping, you know, all that stuff way down that list. Probably maybe even at the bottom of the list is going to church and listening to some guy tell you why you're a sinner, tell you, you know, whatever it is he wants to tell you. All the good stuff about Christmas has nothing to do with Jesus, has nothing to do with Christianity, and a lot of atheists celebrate it. A lot of atheists really enjoy it. Our vice president, Kathy Johnson, has a big Christmas display in her house. It's, of course, a very secular Christmas display because, of course, most of these trappings are secular in nature. Christmas trees, Yule logs, they all come from pagan myths, and they're all completely secular now. And that is the stuff that the preachers hate the most. They hate the fact that you can have all of the best stuff and dump their stuff. Yeah. And that's why they get all unhappy, and that's why we love the phrase skip church, because that be good for goodness sake, skip church, have a great Christmas, enjoy your time, and keep your money.
And keep your money. I don't have the calendar in front of me, so help me out. The date of the Oklahoma City Convention and details for tickets.
The tickets are on sale now. It's at atheists.org. The dates of the event are March 29th through April 1st. It's in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. And by the way, we've got Barry Lynn coming. We've got Inna Shevchenko coming. We've got Anthony Magnabosco coming. We've got you coming. We've got a whole bunch of really fantastic speakers. But most importantly, we're going to be having a really great time. We have a huge charity food packing event coming at this event. We're going to bring the heart. We're going to bring the love. The theme for the convention is atheists coming forth, or atheists showing up for good, hearts plus brains minus assholes. So all the good people are going to be there, and that's what we're going for. You know, it's about being good. It's about being happy. It's about having a fantastic time, bonding with your fellow atheists, learning a little, having a lot of fun. And the venue is right in downtown Oklahoma City, and it's going to be a really a fun event where everybody can have a wonderful time. And I hope everybody comes. Again, the website is atheists.org. And a reminder that tickets to the American Atheist Convention make a great secular Christmas gift.
I'm still, it's at hearts Brains, no assholes.
Brains minus assholes.
Minus assholes. I made a note. That's classic. All right, my friend. You're just down the road from me, so I'm looking forward to seeing you at the convention. All success in the next few months, and we'll continue to watch this sort of fabricated war on Christmas, and we'll watch the billboards and see what people continue to say about them here in the Bible Belt. Thanks for everything you do, my friend.
Thanks a lot, Seth. Take care. See you next time.